Let's welcome Apostle Dr. Dale Devines.
Good day. Greetings in the wonderful name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. This is Apostle Devines, and we continue to give God praise and glory for all that He has done and that He is continuing to do in our lives. This is Pentecost Rally 2022. And so far, we have heard from some mighty men of God, words of encouragement to the body of Christ. Today, I want to continue on the same topic, building together, Nehemiah 4 and verse 6. I pray, God, that you are listening wherever you are and that you are taking notes, because God is speaking to the body of Christ at this time. In Nehemiah 4 and verse 6, the team building together speaks well for those whose mindset is about kingdom advancement. According to the passage, when Sambalat and Tobias heard that Nehemiah had intentions to rebuild the walls of Jerusalem, the Bible says they laughed and they mocked the Jews. They had nothing good to say because they thought to themselves this was an impossible task for the people of God. But may I submit to us here today, what is impossible with men is indeed possible with Almighty God. The Bible tells us that no weapon formed against the church is going to prosper. God is with us. In Ephesians chapter 3 and verses 20, the Bible says, God is able to do exceeding abundantly above all we can think or imagine. Child of God, God can do, God can undo, God can overdo, God can extra do, God can mega do anything beyond human comprehension. Jesus made it very clear when he said, I will build my church and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. As we set out to build together as spiritual institutions, we need to be very vigilant and to guard against a few things. And I want to share with you those few things we need to guard against as we continue this Pentecost Rally 2022. Number one, we need to guard against the spirit of distraction. Hallelujah. Regardless of where you fellowship, hallelujah, and what institution you belong to, the mandate is the same: to glorify God, to edify and equip the body of Christ, to win the lost at all costs, and to destroy the works of the enemy. There is a new generation emerging that is anti-God, a generation that is all-inclusive and love darkness more than light. The distractions are many, and it is easy for the church to lose focus. But I want to encourage the body of Christ today to remain focused on your God-given assignment. We cannot allow the spirit of distraction to distract us from fulfilling our God-given assignment. The Apostle Paul, writing to the Corinthian church in 1 Corinthians 15 and 58, he says, brethren, be steadfast and unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord, for you know that your labor is not in vain in the Lord. We have to guard against the spirit of distraction. I think Nehemiah was guarding against the spirit of distraction. Yes, his friends Sambalat and Tobias was trying to distract the man of God from fulfilling his God-given assignment, but he remained focused. And I feel that the enemy is trying to distract us from fulfilling assignment, and we have to guard against the spirit of distraction in these times. Secondly, hallelujah, we need to guard against the spirit of discouragement. In these uncertain times, we can be certain of the faithfulness of Almighty God. The Bible tells us that God is not slack concerning his promises. Whatever he says, he is going to bring it to pass. Paul, writing to the Philippian church, Paul says, he who has begun a good work in us is able to finish it. When we see all that is happening around us, as preachers, we could become very discouraged and begin to question ourselves. With the rise of false prophets and apostasy, hallelujah, my friend, we could be easily turned off and discouraged. And I could imagine Nehemiah hearing the voices of Sanballat and Tobias and the many others. What are you all trying to do? What are you all trying to do? It will not work. It will not happen. And I could imagine the voices that he was hearing around him from people who seems to be, hallelujah, high up in society. But he remained encouraged. Brothers and sisters, we need to learn how to encourage ourselves in the Lord. We need to learn how to stand our ground and know that we know that we know that with God all things are possible. We need to take courage and rise in faith, believing that God is in control and that he is fighting for us, pushing back darkness in the name of Jesus Christ. In Romans 8:37, the Apostle Paul says, yea, in all these things we are more than conquerors through Christ that loves us. Brothers and sisters, discouragement is going to come. We are going to face it as we rise to build together. We are going to hear the negative voices. We are going to see people laughing and mocking and trying to ridicule the church of the living God. But united, we would stand. Hallelujah. We are a force to be reckoned with. And I want to encourage us today to guard against the spirit of encouragement. God is with us. In Isaiah 40 and verse 10, the prophet says, fear not, be not dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you. I will uphold you with my right hand of righteousness. We need to take courage today and be encouraged that the God of Isaac, the God of Abraham, and the God of Jacob is with us. And because he lives, we are going to face our tomorrow. As we celebrate Pentecost 2022, let's guard against the spirit of discouragement. Let's be encouraged. Let's know who is on our side. The Lord Jehovah is with us. The Lord Jehovah is our God. He is fighting for us. I hear Zechariah says, it's not by might, it's not by power, it's not by our feeble abilities or the wisdom of men, but it's by my spirit, says the Lord God Almighty. God is with us. Be not discouraged, pastors. Be not discouraged, members. Let's take courage and know that this battle belongs to the Lord. Romans 8 and 28, the Apostle Paul says, for this we know, but all things work together for good to them that love God and to those who are called according to his purpose. Let's guard against destruction. Let's guard against division. Third here today, we need to guard against the spirit of division. No church can survive in isolation. The more fragmented we are, the less impact we would have. No church is better than any church. We have all been given an assignment by God. The Bible says one of these days we would stand before God to give an account, all of us, of the things we have done here on the earth. Mark 3:24 tells us, but the kingdom divided against itself shall never stand. Our battle is not against flesh and blood. The Apostle Paul, writing to the Ephesians church in chapter 6, he says, for we wrestle not against flesh and blood. but against principalities, against powers, against spiritual wickedness in high places, against the rulers of darkness of this age. We have to guard against the spirit of division. According to the passage we would have read in Nehemiah 4 and verses 6, the entire chapter, the Bible says that the people had a mind to work. They were in one mission. They had one goal. They had one vision, and that was to rebuild the walls of Jerusalem, to rebuild the broken walls, to rebuild that which was broken, preventing security and safety to the people of God. It's time in the book of John, Jesus prayed that we be one. In Psalms 133, the Bible says, "Behold, how good and pleasant and lovely it is for brethren to dwell together in unity." As we build together, we have to guard against the spirit of division. Child of God, Satan wants to divide us, and if he divides us, then we would have no impact. But to God be the glory. We are so thankful for this team that we are working together to rebuild whatever that was broken in the name of Jesus Christ. Child of God, you hear me today. We have to guard against the spirit of division. The Bible says to mark them that create division among us and to avoid them. In the book of Proverbs, the wise man says, "These 6 things the Lord hates, and the 7 is an abomination unto the Lord. He that soweth discord among the brethren." Child of God, God hates disunity. God hates it when we function fragmented, when we work against each other, when we pull down one another, when we refuse to restore and reconcile our relationship one with another. God hates disunity. God cannot move as he would like where there is division. That's why unity is so precious. And we have to fight for unity. We have to guard against the spirit of division as we strive to work together, as we strive to build together and restore all that was broken in the name of Jesus Christ. Unity is one of the most powerful forces we have and can use against the assignment of the enemy. Jesus himself prayed and he says, "Oh God, Father, I pray that they be one, even as you and I are one." Hallelujah. God believes in unity. When we unite, the powers of darkness cannot penetrate us. When we unite, the powers of darkness cannot defeat us. When we unite, there is no weak link. Hallelujah. We stand with each other. We support each other. We pray for one another. We forgive each other. We love one another. When we unite, there is power in the name of Jesus Christ. And even as we celebrate Pentecost 2022, I want to encourage us this midday hour to guard against the spirit of distraction. Whatever is coming our way, whatever is trying to hinder us from fulfilling our assignment, let's guard against it. Let's guard against the spirit of discouragement. Let's learn how to encourage ourselves in the Lord. Psalms 34, David says, "I will bless the Lord at all times, and his praises shall continually be in my mouth. My soul will make a boast in the Lord, and the humble will hear thereof and be glad." Oh, magnify the Lord with me, and let's exalt his name together. "For I sought the Lord, and he heard me, and delivered me from all my fears." You You hear me? There are things happening around us that could discourage us, but we have to learn to square our shoulders and remind ourselves of who we are and who we belong to, and to remind ourselves that our God is still a champion. Our God is still a champion. Our God is still on the throne. And because he lives, we will face our tomorrow. Let not your heart be troubled. If you believe in God, John says, believe also in the Lord Jesus Christ. Child of God, this midday hour, I want to tell you, be encouraged. God is for us. God is with us. God is going to help us in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. To God be the glory. We have to guard against the spirit of division. I said also, don't allow anybody, don't allow anything. We can't allow our doctrines, we can't allow how we feel or the flesh to divide us as a spiritual institution. The world is in darkness, and the Bible says that we are the light of the world. We are still the salt of the earth, and we cannot allow the things around us to divide us as the body of Christ. Nehemiah faced those three things and more. He faced distractions. He faced discouragement. And even within the camp, he may have faced division. There may have been folks wondering, what is he doing? There may have been folks wondering what is going on, but to God be the glory, he remained focused. And even as we celebrate Pentecost 2022, let us remain focused. For God did not give us a spirit of fear, but of love and of power and of a sound mind. We are overcomers. We are more than conquerors. The church of God was born in fire, and we refuse to live in smoke. The church of God is moving forward. The church of God is alive and well. Wherever you are across this world, wherever you are hearing my voice, let it be known this day that the church of God is alive and well. The Bible says, and when the day of Pentecost was fully come, the Spirit of God came and breathed upon man. Child of God, we are encountering, we are living in one of the greatest era of our time, where we would see the manifestation of the power of Almighty God. We are going to see the glory of God return to our full gospel churches. We are going to see the presence of God operating again. We are going to see signs and wonders, because the Spirit of God will not fail. In the book of Joel, the Bible says, in the last days, I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh. Child of God, we are in those days where God is about to restore everything the canker worm may have eaten, everything the palmer worm may have eaten. Tell the devil, look out, the church is on the rise. I did not say denomination, I did not say organization, I said the church, the ecclesia, is on the rise. God will be glorified. God would be exalted. God would be magnified. I encourage you today, be not discouraged. Do not be distracted. Don't encourage division, but remain focused, so that the power and the presence of God can indeed fill our nation. God bless you today. I pray, God, that something said would have encouraged your heart at this midday hour. Know that the God I'm talking about is the God who is omnipotent, omniscient, and omnipresent. The God who is forever faithful. The God who is a winner and will never lose a battle. I encourage you this midday hour, arise and shine, for the glory of the Lord is upon us. Apostle Devine saying, let's rise and build together. Let's build back what is broken. Build back healthy friendships. Build back good relationships. Build back, hallelujah, the fear of Almighty God in our day and time. Have a wonderful lunch hour, and may God continue to prosper you. May God continue to enlarge your territory. And please be reminded that the giant in front of us is never bigger than the God inside of us. God bless you. Happy Pentecost 2022.
Shaken, we will not be moved. Jesus, you are.